Hey, Paolo from Trivium. I'm going to show you some of the gear I use up here on stage. I have my Warwick Corvette Double Buck. The Double Buck means these pickups right here. They do active and passive, which is sort of like different styles of pickups. They do both. I can adjust with these knobs and switches right here. Gets tons of different good tones. Been playing Warwick now for a couple years, like maybe three at this point. Some of the best basses I've ever used, as you can tell, incredible woodwork. I love them, you know. I don't think I'd ever be able to go back to anything else. This is definitely one of the best basses I've ever used. So yeah, I keep all these knobs at different settings. This is the volume, obviously, you have that the whole way up. This one is like a split between the two pickups. Keep that in the middle. This is for the front pickup here by the neck. I keep that the whole way up. This is for the back one. I keep that just past midway, which is right about there. Keep those in the middle. It's pretty solid. It's pretty high-endy. I like a lot of high-end in the mix. Obviously keep some bass in there, but I like to cut through. And then I give our front of house guy the option to kind of cut back and roll off some of the high end to what he needs. So that usually is best of both worlds for the mix. For the strings, I use Dunlop Super Brights. I believe I'm using a 135 right now on the top here on this lowest string, and then it goes all the way up to a 45. Pretty standard, I would say that's like a medium gauge. I don't like the action to be too high or too low, sort of in the middle. I try to play it pretty, you know, pretty solidly in the middle range. This is all I use right here. I don't use cabinets. This is a Kemper Profiler. It's a profile of an Ampeg Classic head, an 8x10 Ampeg cabinet. I got it off the Kemper forum. There's tons of profiles on there. And what a profile is just a, pretty much through this weird process of putting a mic up to a real cabinet and sending it through the Kemper, it profiles it digitally, so it like maps it out. It is almost indistinguishable from the real thing. I would say, especially for bass, you'd never be able to tell the difference. I use in-ears, so all my sound is going into my in-ear monitor mix. We don't use any wedges on stage, there's no cabinets. Very clean mix. The thing I love about the Kemper, it's so portable. We can fly with them if we need to. We have an entire rig of these in Europe as well, so we don't have to fly back and forth with them, but they're so portable, and to be able to take, you know, the sound you want and have it consistent every single night, never have any sort of variables like the way the club sounds affecting the miking on the cabs, it just takes so much out of the equation. And you know, we're pretty lucky. We don't have too many major technical difficulties. I think by keeping it simple, using these, sticking with the in-ears, it's been the best for us. I've been using cabs before we switched over to kind of going totally direct. I was using cabs since I was young. I did have an Ampeg at one point that I lent someone on a tour. It got stolen. I never got it back. That was the end of using Ampegs because, you know, I just, at that point, was not able to get any endorsements. I had played custom amps. I had played PV, which were great amps. We still work with PV, especially in the studio. We love using 5150s for the guitar tones. So, you know, the thing is, it's the best of both worlds, using real amps in the studio and live using the Kempers, being able to always have our tones, being able to back things up, to update stuff, keep it with us so when we fly over to Europe we can update anything we changed in America and vice versa. Made the switch to DI probably like 7 years ago, first with like a Sans amp, and then Corey and Matt moved to Fractal, which was awesome, but then we discovered Kemper, and then we all made the switch to Kemper at once, and that was sort of like the game changer for us. It's very simple to use. I would say that's the one thing I like more than the Fractal. You know, I still have a Fractal at home that I'll use sometimes for like guitar stuff, but it's just so user friendly. And when you're playing a live show, I just love that it's still set up like a regular amp, because that was always the best part of like analog stuff. It's like you just walk back if you need to change something. You don't have to like go through a whole process. Super easy to use. They sound great. I don't think I could ever go back to like using cabs. It's like totally changed the way I play bass, especially with in-ears. It's just like a different feel, a different way to play. You can't really hide any of your mistakes with in-ears and the Kemper. So it's made me push myself to try to be, you know, the best bass player I can be. All right, so my MIDI pedal really doesn't have too much stuff going through it. Corey and Matt have more of theirs. Mine's mainly just for the tuning. Tuner on the Kemper is great, it's precise. I don't switch basses during the show, I just stick with one and I'll just tune up and down. And I know it kind of feels a little different when you drop tune compared to like the normal standard tuning, but I've just kind of gotten used to it. And again, I just don't like things changing in the set. Like, I will feel the slightest difference between the two different basses, and I'd rather just stick with the main one unless something happens and I have to switch. But it makes things easier, takes a little bit of a burden off our guitar tech so we can focus on Corey and Matt most of the show because they got more guitar changes. This Shure wireless here is, what is that? UR4D Plus. That's one of the higher end ones. Again, we made the switch a couple years ago. We've been using wirelesses before, definitely using Shure. But, you know, when you start to get into just using direct, your signal matters so much because, like, that's it. Like, this and this is the tone. And the signal from the wireless does matter. It can definitely make a big difference. I've heard the difference between a couple versions lower of the Shure and this one, and it's night and day. You know, you're gonna have to pay for it. But when you don't have, like, a backline or anything, cabs, you know, you can really, really tell the difference. Okay, so the in-ears that I use and that we all use, JH Audio, which is actually located in Orlando, Florida, which is super convenient for us. This model of their in-ears is called the JH16, 16 drivers in it. I want to say that's pretty much like the lows, mids, and the highs. You know, it has multiple drivers for each. It sounds like you're listening to a live mix, or excuse me, a live album. It's so much low-end capability, which is obviously great for me, for bass. You know, the drums sound incredible, vocals sound pristine, guitars and everything are sitting in the mix, so if you got a really good mix going, these sound incredible. I've probably had these now because I've gotten two different updates, I think, since I first started. But these are probably about 3-4 years old. So it's probably going to be time for a new set soon because your ears sort of change after a while. But again, this is like game changer. You know, first in-ears I used were like they're called the E5s by Shure, which were great. Great starting point, but they weren't molded to your ear. These are molded, and you can do like your own artwork if you want, like our Oni skull, and it sounds great. Like, if you want to play with in-ears, definitely JH, because they have a whole range. Like, these are some of their top end, but I have a set of J5s, which I think they've changed to another thing now. Maybe it's the J4, J6, JH6, I should say. They sound great. You know, Alex has been using some of those. They sound killer. Just really depends on the preference you want. I like the low end, so the 16s are what I like to use. Thank you guys for checking out my gear. The Trivium Arch Enemy Tour is still going around North America and Canada. Definitely come out if you can. If not, or if you're coming, you should definitely check out our new album, The Sin of the Sentence. It's out. It's on Spotify, Apple Music stores, everywhere you can find music. Check it out. We're really proud of it. We're really proud of all the gear we got here that helped us make it, and I hope you enjoy it.